What's the secret to a Bobby Burger?
The secret is the secret is to keep it, you know, a lot simpler than people think. I start with to me, I think of the burger as the quintessential sandwich. You have to think about every single component of a burger,
right?
And then put it together. It's not easy making a good sandwich. So, you know, we start with terrific certified Angus beef. And then it's the right ratio of beef to fat in terms of, we use sort of an 80-20 mix, which is, that's kind of classic. It's 80% beef, 20% fat. You have to have enough fat in there for flavor and obviously to keep it juicy,
right,
as it's cooking. And then, there are certain things that we do. You know, we season it really well with salt and pepper on both sides. I teach my cooks in Bobby's Burger Pals the same, fundamentals and techniques that I would teach, my cooks in my high-end restaurants, and then simple things. There's actually a sign in the restaurant, in the kitchen, the customers don't see,
right,
that the cooks look at all day long, that says melt the cheese completely. when there's a piece of cheese on a burger and they haven't spent the extra 20 seconds, melting the cheese, just makes it taste better, makes it look better, and just makes the whole experience better.
You're an artist, the way a guitar player would play with the guitar to come up with the perfect chords to write the perfect song. I see you that way with food. You know, the way you just explained that burger, how much influence, have you had? Is any of this Grandma Flay's stuff handed down, or is this all Bobby just messing with the meat?
No, it's definitely me for sure. I don't come from a long line of great chefs or cooks or anything like that, but, I think the key to our success at Bobby's Burger Pals is the fact that, it's not a fancy burger. It has great technique. It's got great ingredients, high quality. All the people that work in the restaurants are so passionate about what we do there.
Mm-hmm.
They're proud that, that we serve sort of the best burger you can buy. And so when as a customer, I think that when we first opened, people were like, oh, Bobby Flay's opening these burger places. They're going to be expensive and they're going to be fancy. The bottom line is that they're affordable and they look like and taste like the best burger you've ever had. And that's really the key. I mean, we do some special things, there's different sort of flavors of the burger itself.
Right.
But the bottom line is that the basic burger itself is the same. I don't put, and this is people ask me about this all the time. Like, what do you put in the meat? I don't put anything in the meat. Like, I don't put any onions or garlic or chilies or anything in the meat itself.
Right.
I always say that's meatloaf, and we're making burgers.
Yeah, that's a very good point.
Yeah, we put the condiments on top of the burger. So the Philly style burger would have provolone cheese and
right,
peppers and onions, and so we try to bring flavors from around the country, right on top of the burger.
You are, you're in great shape. You're a charismatic guy. You talk about moderation, but with you being around food all day, how do you not blow up like a balloon?
You know what? Honestly, it's really hard. I mean, food is my friend, but it can also be a hazard if you're not careful.
Mm-hmm.
I'm always in my kitchens and I'm always cooking in my restaurants. And, the only way to know that you're serving, food the right way is by tasting it. So, I'm constantly eating, which I'm not complaining about it, but I know that I have to be careful. I make a few rules. I have to go to the gym. I got to run down, I have to run a few miles every once in a while. I have to stay active and just be careful. And I always say that, I've been on the cheeseburger diet my whole life, and I'm hanging in there.
I'd gladly pay you on Tuesday for a burger today.
Exactly.
You know what? If I know, it's all about very basic with you, but when you're talking about toppings, if you were going to create the ultimate Jersey burger, and all about Jersey, what would be some Jersey toppings you would put on a Jersey burger?
They talk about, Taylor ham and stuff like that. This is actually the perfect time of the year for Jersey, because, those tomatoes are coming right
now. Yeah.
As we speak, people think as soon as the summer hits, Jersey tomatoes are perfect. But the bottom line is that, August, September, that's the time for Jersey tomatoes. And I think that I think the Jersey tomato is one of the best ingredients, not just Jersey but anywhere in the country. And so I would create something, you know, not just put a slice of tomato on a burger. I mean, anybody can do that.
Right.
But if you created like a Jersey tomato salsa or a Jersey tomato relish or a Jersey tomato conserve, something like that, where you brought other ingredients in, sort of like a sweet and sour kind of thing, where it was like maybe, you know, some Jersey tomatoes cooked like maybe for maybe 45 seconds in a pan, and you put some honey and some vinegar and some chilies and some fresh, you know, Jersey basil in there, and then put that on top of a burger. I mean, to me, that would really enhance it at the same time.
See, you're an artist. You are an artist. Bobby, Bobby's Burger Palace celebrating 10 years. Tomorrow, Bobby Flay will be at the Monmouth Mall, 5 o'clock. Thanks so much for coming on. It's been a pleasure having you. Now I'm hungry.
I look forward to seeing all your listeners tomorrow night.
You got it, Bobby. Thanks again.
I appreciate it.